السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. People in their reaction to the hardships and things that happen to them are different types. There are some people that whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test them with any problem, they do not accept it, they reject it, they think that it should not happen to them. And the reaction to this problem or to this test will be with their heart and their tongue and their body parts. The reaction with the heart will be that they will not accept it, they reject it, they said it should not happen to them. They are good, they didn't do anything wrong. And this has nothing to do, by the way, with the test. Because the prophets and the messengers and the righteous and the pious, they were the best. And still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them. And the test of the prophets reached the point that حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه متى نصر الله. To the point that the prophets and the messenger that because of the tense of the hardship and the problem that they had, they used to say, when is the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala coming? Those people who do not accept the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or the test of Allah azza wa jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about them in the Quran by saying, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةَ وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٌ اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةٌ انْقَلَبَ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةَ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينُ. This ayah means there are some people that worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he says ala harf, yani they are on the edge literally, but here the meaning is they are good in their worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as long as everything is good with them. They are healthy, they're wealthy, they're good, no problem, everything is fine, they had no issues, so they are praying and doing everything. So this is the meaning of the ayah. But as soon as Allah Azza wa Jal test them with any problem, with any issue, immediately all these types of worship, they stop completely. Because they think that if I'm worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I have been inflicted with this, so what is the benefit of that? Allah Azza wa Jal says, يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ. They are like an edge. You know when you get to an edge and you're about to slip? That's exactly the situation of those people. يَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى حَرْفٍ. فَإِنْ أَصَابَهُ خَيْرٍ. If things are good, اطْمَأَنَّ بِهِ. خلاص. He rest assured. No problem. Everything is fine. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةً. Fitna in the ayah means test. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةً. And if there's a test of any kind, a test in his health, in his children, a test in his job, a test in his life in general, it doesn't matter what kind of test it is. This is the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ فِتْنَةً انْقَلَبَ عَلَى وَجْهِهِ خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةَ. Subhanallah. He يعني goes to the opposite direction. And instead of going into the right path, he goes completely to the wrong way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خَسِرَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةَ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. He lost this life and he lost the hereafter. How did he lose his life? This life? He lost this life by, he is being inflected, he's being tested. Things are not good. So basically this is a loss for him. And he lost the hereafter by not being patient over what happens to him, and because of that, the hereafter is also gone. So both of them are already gone. This is not the way of the believers. The way of the believers is whenever good things happen to them, they say, Alhamdulillah, alladhi bi ni'matihi tatimmu as-salihat. Praise be to Allah with whose blessing good things happen. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ And if bad things happen to them, they say, Alhamdulillahi ala kulli hal. Praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway. And when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, who's the most afflicted people in this? Who's the most afflicted person? Or who are the most afflicted people in this world? He said the prophets and then the righteous and then the next to them in piety and righteousness. So this is the first type of people in their reaction to the disasters, their reaction to the problems, their reaction to the hardship. So try your best not to be of this kind of people. So this is their reaction with their hearts. The reaction with the tongue is they say bad words. Why me? Why it happened to me? Why only me? Why I'm the one that is receiving all these problems? Why other people are having a good life and I don't? This is actually rejecting the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the tongue. And the rejection with the body parts, that was explained by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his hadith when he said, "Laysa minna man latama al-khudud wa shaqqa al-jiyub wa da'a bi da'wa al-jahiliyya." Latama al-khudud, slapping the faces. And shaqqa al-jiyub, they tear the clothes. وَدَعَى بِدَعْوَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يَا وَيْلَهِ يعني woe to us. What a disaster. What a crisis. The Prophet ﷺ said, those people do not belong to us. They don't belong to the followers, the true followers of the Prophet ﷺ. So this is the reaction with the body parts. That you see them at the time of the disaster because they cannot think at any time that this thing will happen to them. They start like latm al-khudud and shaq al-jiyub and doing all these kind of things. So this is the first type of people in their reaction to the disaster. The second type of people, which is, يعني, inshallah, much better than this, it is patience. It is patience. Sabr. And patience means that the person, he knows that this is a problem and he bears with it. يعني, he suffers. And it's not easy for him. He is not pleased with it. He accepts it, but he is not pleased with it. He bears with it in a way that, you know, it's a decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but I'm going to take it anyway. And I'm going to be patient. So this type of people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them the ajr azim, or the great reward of those who are patient, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ Give the good news to the patient. When they are afflicted with the problem, they say, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ Indeed, we belong to Allah, and indeed, one day, we shall return to Him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He says the musiba, يعني إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ does not apply only at the situation of death. يعني any problem happen to the person, any hardship, any difficulty, any crisis, says, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ Even from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that like when the Muslim is sleeping at the night time and he turns from one side to another, he also says, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Subhanallah. Yani we have Safwan ibn al-Mu'attal, radiallahu ta'ala anhum, when he was left behind in the army during the Battle of Bani al-Mustaliq, and once he found Aisha, radiallahu ta'ala anha, left behind the army, And then he came and he found the mother of the believers, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What was the first thing that he said? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. The wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then he took her and went all the way to Medina. And that's the story of the ifk, or the false accusation against Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. No time يعني, to give the details about this one. But the point is, يعني, it was a big thing. And then he immediately said, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. So anyway, those people, or this second type of people, they are patient. They take it, and they are patient over it because they know that there is a reward for patience. And they bear with it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them with the reward of those who are patient. لَهُمْ أَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَ So this is the second type of people in their reaction to the disaster or to the problem. The third type of people is higher than the patients. يعني they are not only patient, but they accept it. Not only accept it, but they are pleased with it. They are pleased with it. يعني they are happy that something like this happened to them. Why? Because they knew that this is going to take away from their bad deeds. This is going to raise their position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is going to get them closer to the position of the prophets and the messengers, the martyrs, the righteous, the truthful. So they do not only accept the test, but they are pleased with it. And they knew that it is good for them anyway, because they are true believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the type of people that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talked about when he said, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إن أمره كله خير له إن أصابته ضراء صبر فكان خيرا له وإن أصابته سراء شكر فكان خيرا له. Amazing is the situation of the believer. When he is being tested with any problem, he is patient and he accepts it with pleasure, and this is good for him. And when a blessing is given to him, granted to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is thankful, and this is also good for him. So this is the second type, or the third type of people in their reaction to the problem and the disaster. They accept, they bear with it, and they are pleased with it. And the last, but not the least, it's a higher position than this one. We're going all the way from down all the way to the top. So the last one, which is not the least of them, it is the top level. It is the top type or group of people. In their reaction to the test and the disaster, they are not only patient, they are patient. They do not only accept it, they accept it. They are not only pleased with it, they are pleased with it. But on the top of that, they thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for it. They thank Allah azza wa jal for it. And they become thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَشْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَلَى هَذِهِ الْمُصِيبَةِ يشكرون الله عز وجل. They are grateful to Allah and they are pleased with it, and they knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in his hadith, which means if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves his servant, he will test him. If he is pleased with that, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will select him. يعني will take him as the elite, as the best of the people, will get him closer and closer to him. So these are different types of people in their reaction to the disasters. Some people do not accept, they reject, they turn, they retreat on their heels to the opposite direction. Some people, they become just patient, and they know that there is a reward for patience. Some people, they become pleased with it. And last but not the least, to those who thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that test, because they knew that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves them. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من هؤلاء الذين يشكرون الله سبحانه وتعالى ويرضون بما قسم الله عز وجل لهم ويرضون بما امتحنهم الله واختبرهم في هذه الحياة الدنيا إنه على ما يشاء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى ومن العمل ما ترضى برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واستر عيوبنا واشرح صدورنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك آمالنا. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في ديننا ودنيانا وأهلينا وأموالنا. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا. اللهم احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ومن فوقنا، ونعوذ بعظمتك اللهم أن نغتال من تحتنا. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.